paths, drawn to the fire between them. No matter if it the flame was desire, despair, or hate.
I hereby resign from service as maid and house.
Seeing you like this. You're not well. You were sweating and shaking all night, and now there you are locked in your workshop as usual. This whole tortured artist nonsense has got to stop.
It's not like I'm some drunkard. I know how to handle my liquor.
You keep the fire in your office just to stop me, don't you? You hate me that much? Me away.
I keep the fire because I'm freezing, for God's sake.
Minced mice, chunky, crunchy, carcasses starving me out, constantly sick.
All I asked for was an edible meal. At least one that had any taste at all. This is my house. You can't keep locking me in. You're so afraid of fire. How can you cut off the means of escape?
Thank you.
Suddenly, everything I find relaxing is a fire hazard. By the flames, finish it!
Calculations you asked for. You need to also include the cost of lamps for every room.
I don't care how much it costs. She's afraid of fire. We will have electricity, and that is that.
Let's talk about the symbolic aspects of your work.
I'd rather not.
Why is that?
A symbolism is a word that gets thrown around a lot, usually when people don't really know what to make of you. The worst question you could possibly ask me is, what did you mean by that? If it was that simple, I wouldn't have painted it. I would have just told you. Of course, we can talk in general about themes that have always inspired me. Duality, conflict. I think that all art revolves around some sort of struggle. Whether or not we're able to see it, of course, is an entirely different matter. Perfect, striking, vibrant life, 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 fire! Why did you stop? That dude was perfect. Honey, please, just a little longer. At least until I finish painting this one part. Oh, don't make me beg.
Here are the calculations, yes.
I mean, I've seen you in my house. Oh.
Lice, mice, bald, bloody spots, hair, not mine. Where are the scissors?
Thank you.
Oh, stop looking at me like that. It's just a little something to help me focus on my work, that's all.
Nothing. They're getting smart. Honey, remember how you said it would be nice to have a cat so the baby could have someone to play with? Well, I just bought us a dog. Aww. You always wanted to have a huge garden. Green calmed your nerves, you said. Is this the right door for me? Darkness.
come to that. But here we are. I will protect myself.
Since my last letter, things only got worse. Yesterday, a stool broke underneath me. My cup stuck to a kitchen table. We need new servants. But these people are so lazy. It's like nobody wants to work anymore.
Ass up today. I'm resigning from work at this house. I think I don't have to explain reasons. You know how life in this house looks. If I could give you some advice, think about being more understanding and a bit nicer to future servants.
I'm done. I'll do it myself. Keeping the house from breaking apart can't be that hard. Understand, I'm working in here! I swear, if I'm interrupted one more time... I thought it would be harder. It should be harder. Bones shouldn't break so easily. only thing that could make her smile. I needed to remove the flesh from the bone. At first, I was lost as to how, but then I sawed it off with a handsaw, boiled it, then put the bone in a mortar. I had to get one, obviously. This was not something I'd done before. Finally, I mixed the dust with some white paint. It made for a lovely undercoat. Honey, what in the world are you doing? What did the doctor say about straining yourself? Leave that thing alone. It's not going anywhere.
Hello. It's about time for us to talk, don't you think? I mean, I've seen you in my house so many times, and yet I could never find the courage to face you directly. Not until now.
Minced mice.
It's not like I'm some drunkard.
Lice, mice, spawn.
Their life started to fall apart. Everything he touched turned to rot.